There are a number of reasons to take a robotic approach to understanding how fish swim. One is that when you study live fish, there are only so many things you can convince a live fish to do. And when you can build a robot, you can move the fins in ways that a live fish could not do. And so you can explore biological questions with a robot by asking, is the fish moving its fins, for example, in a way that generates the maximum amount of force possible? Or are there other ways to move the fin that might be better? And you can use a robot to answer those questions. So in order to study how fish swim, we've attached a very simple physical model of a flexing and bending fish to a robotic device. This robotic device is going to swim against an imposed current. Now I'm going to turn the flow up, and the water is going to move past the swimming robot. As I turn it up higher and higher, the robot moves back. And then as I turn it slower and slower here, you can see the robot moves forward. And in the middle, there's a speed at which the robot is self-propelling. That is, it's generating just enough force to match the drag that it encounters by the current moving past it. And we've also been very fortunate, been able to have students come in and do independent projects in the lab, explore their own ideas.
If I'm studying fish shapes, looking at any shape would be impossible. There are every different sorts of shapes, from eels to tuna. What I want to do is focus on shapes that are of importance either to the fish biomechanically or to engineers who are trying to design robots and things that will go underwater. One of those shapes is the back of a fish, where the tail meets the body. And it's been suggested that the deeper that cut goes into the body, the narrower the back of the body is, the more efficient a fish will be. Because tuna and pike are essentially the archetypes for this sort of study, tuna are very narrow at the back and pike are very big at the back, I call this my tuna model. Conversely, I have this model here, which I call my pike model, and you can see it's a lot deeper. It's not as narrow as the tuna model. So this might actually have very different hydrodynamics, very different swimming properties than my tuna model that's swimming right now. Even though these models may seem very simple, it's very informative about what features might influence the design of a fish or the shape of a fish that actually contribute to swimming performance.
Collaborative work with engineers and physical scientists has been absolutely essential, and it's been one of the most rewarding aspects of my career. Our most important collaborator has been Professor James Tangora's group at Drexel University. He has a tremendous group of engineers there who are outstanding at developing aquatic robotic devices, and working with him, we believe we're very close to developing a fully functional whole fish robot with each fin capable of being controlled and moved in a way that will imitate for the first time the performance of a live fish.